we talked about how they need a heavy hitting AP champion. There's very few options that are actually available in the jungle. Sejuani's there, but the enemy team already has a Braum.
And up to us.
Whoa, that's a Flash Cocoon. Lehen style on the top side. They may still just get this kill as a rappel. Gonna stay in the sky for a very long time and decides to go back. As Khan does have the World Ender and picks up the first blood.
In order to get her experience from the camps. She's not a jungler that wants to constantly be farming.
Oh, that's the Cocoon. Lands it this time. And yep, Umbral Dash gets Khan in range. That's a free one. Teleporting back to lane feels real bad as Mata times. And works pretty well. But we're going to have a look at this highlight once again. Yeah. As I'm actually a little bit upset about it because it's just so frustrating. He's... Almost. And then we make sure we get the missed Flash Cocoon.
Yep, the missed Flash Cocoon.
In fact, like, both of these flashes are almost unnecessary.
Well,
Tal dies. Khan decides he'll come back.
Yep.
And I guess you could understand, maybe there wasn't a vision of where Urgot was at that particular point in time, so he felt like he couldn't actually go through the enemy jungle. Might be a way of thinking about it.
Yeah, yep, for sure. And then right here, he should...
These guys beating the heck out of each other, and here's a teleport, Mata. Gonna get the Devour and the Flash. Good slowdown here from the Iceborne Gauntlet. The teleport back is Tal. Gonna get the ultimate. That's a lot of ticks. And Teddy instantly dies. Khan wondering what the heck he's doing down here because there's a double kill going on around him.
Yeah, and still able to get a kill there.
That's the ultimate actually coming down from King. Clid secures the kill in the end. But Teddy, that was all about you, my friend. Beautiful play.
Right now. They're going to get that mid-tier one and then maybe try to use the Mountain Drake as the next main focal point fight.
Yeah, and they are going to get themselves a lot more lane priority, I guess, or at least map priority. That's a good knock up there from Faker. They just get a free Braum, take down the turret. Bono is one hit away from dead. It's the flash forward, decimating smash from Faker. That looked too good as Sungyoon's going to die as well. Tempt looking on his horror as everyone...
We're about to have a 7k gold lead potentially and a Mountain Drake on the side of SK Telecom.
Yeah,
this
once
game
again.
Is looking very similar to game number one in the sense that it's looking quite over. Mountain Drake to boot. We'll see what the second spawn is. Obviously, SK Telecom probably praying for another mountain. Get on an Infernal. Can't complain about
Faker
that.
Protecting his top laner. Oh, okay.
Oh, he got it canceled. I'm like, wait a minute.
Yeah, that's an interesting one. But Tal's just going to go down. Cancel does come in, I believe, from Tempt on
turret.
The
turret. Surely going to fall here.
All right, there's the train. Unbreakable. Not going to be enough to get rid of that damage as Sungyoon has to get the hell out of there with his ultimate True Shot Barrage! Picks off the Kai'Sa! They're in a choke point. Teddy having a field day on the Ezreal. Really nice aim, and they'll take two inner turrets. It looks like SKT has Baron right now without even having the Baron.
Yeah, this game is completely turning on its head. And this is what you would like to see with these kinds of gold leads and what you would expect out of a team of this caliber.
Yeah.
And, you know, coming into the series tonight, we were talking about, well, who's the third best team in Korea? Don't let the standings deceive you.
It looks like it was in a weird direction, but nothing's going to come of it. There's the flash in. Tal wants to find it, but Teddy in the right position. True Shot Barrage means that Tal just does absolutely no damage and dies basically instantly. That was what Hanwha wanted, and now they're going to find everything. The knockups, the decimating smash. The Q coming in from the Aatrox, and Khan helps just wipe the floor with Hanwha Life. Abyssal Voyage means they're not done yet. Key gonna go down, Infernal Chains not going to arm, but Tempt is dead on the bottom side, and SKT are looking for a clean ace at 22 minutes with a broken base already.
Yeah, I actually think this is the game because Faker, even if they kill him, Sion passive is able to persist on, but the members coming up, I mean, you have Thal, but he doesn't have his ultimate available. There's a sizable minion wave demolish on some of these champions.
Yep, we are going to stack up these demolish procs, but look, both Nexus turrets dying at about the same time. Five members of SKT closing in on this Nexus.
Okay.
They are going to back away as Thal doesn't have Slicing Maelstrom. How about an Infernal Drake? SKT will pick that one up. Looking to go to the Baron next. Not what you want. As Faker's is going to try it again without his ultimate this time, as Hanwha Life are in a position to actually get punished by this. Good Unbreakable denies the True Shot Barrage, but there's just too much money on SKT. Tempt has to just see his death, gets knocked up and smacked down by SKT.
And that's going to be the end of the game with Urgot falling. There's no way the Hanwha Life team composition can resist this. Down 15,000 gold in an Infernal.
Yeah, 15,000 gold, but also there's no Nexus turrets here either. Oh, that knock-up onto Sungyoon was disgusting as Bono takes half of his health bar just from incidental damage Hum Alive, they will try it again with the Slicing Maelstrom. Can they actually get it done? Vikkan has the World Ender. They've got the Infernal Chains. They've got Faker in there with the Decimating Smash, and they don't even care about winning the game right now. They want more kills. SKT wants a clean 2-0, and man, it doesn't come much cleaner than that, bar maybe a weird face check and this dance on the enemy fountain. SKT feels like they're back, but we'll have to see against some different opposition.
Yeah. And tonight's series, very, very decisive and one-sided.
Yeah.
Whereas the SK Telecom versus Hanwha Life games tonight, and Faker on the Scion actually did quite a considerable amount of work, and it's such an interesting dynamic. He's playing these tanks and these engagey champions because he actually has teammates this year.
So he does. And also, we saw like those plays with like the Faker of old, that flash decimating smash right on the edge, getting the knock up that allowed them to snowball through the mid lane so much more effectively. This felt like a Faker on, you know, years gone past form rather than